Welcome back, everybody. We've got Peter versus Killerfish. This is map number two after Peter had a pretty convincing performance on map number one. And we're going to be live right into pistol round here. Killerfish on their T side. We're going to see how this is going to work out for him already. They've got one up on the boost spot. He's going to fall down into mid. And yeah, we can see that Spiker already dealt a significant amount of damage. Waterfalls, though, takes down Tossin. So the mid flank completely out of the picture. It's now only going to be just a straight-up A execute.
And Peter has the numbers in the back, but is it going to matter? No, it's not. Wow. Killerfish, wow. All three entries into the bomb site. AM, Q, and Waylander. Oh, man, just Waylander now. One on four. Got to hit nothing but heads. There's the first one. Often the hardest. Now three to B. Gets flashed. How many more nades does the T side have? That was the last one. So now a straight up firefight. Waylander looking for anybody to peek him. Killerfish don't really need to be taking these fights until he works his way up. And yeah, Waylander's going to save his armor. He's not going to go for this on pistol round. Oh, come on, man. You got to go for this pistol round. Saving your armor for the next. That is, that's pretty passive from the Peter side. And on a pistol round, you know, they don't have nades. Go for that. One on three. Go for that.
Yeah, and he ends up just playing that A main angle, and ammo just finds him and one taps him nonetheless. So Killerfish with a nice pistol round to start, and important that they have some momentum on their side as they were beaten pretty decently. It wasn't completely a one-sided show, but Inferno definitely went the way of Peter. And now it's their turn to show us what they got on cash and some results, some historical stats on this map for Killerfish. They actually did beat MyKPV 2-0. And for the first map was Mirage, but second one they won was 16-11 on cash. So a decent performance there. And Peter, they actually faced off against Melty and LDLC White on this map. And it was 19-17. So an overtime victory versus Melty, and then 19-15, an overtime loss versus LDLC White. So we'll see here as both teams, they've proven that they have something to show on this map. So it could prove to be an interesting one. Ammo takes down Waterfalls to open up the round as they take in a mid here. So good control early on, but Jimka going to fire into Oscarish. And this is an armor pistol buy, and Jimka finds another one, making it very expensive. And this is looking like the tides may turn early on here.
Yeah, it could be going to Peter here. Both members of Killerfish very low in the end. Tossin now all alone here at the B-bomb site. Once again, Peter, ton of HP compared to Tossin's 18. Basecrack has picked up that fallen waterfall scout. And now Tossin, 25 seconds left. Doesn't want to give up this round, but so little to work with here. Going to try to fall back. Basecrack pushed up inside of the heaven and takes out Tossin. So right back. Is Peter, they go down one player early, that's Waterfalls, but JM over at B starts things off with a good 5-7 shot, and just like that, everybody falls down for Killerfish. So, Killerfish going to respond with a force buy of their own? Yes, we are. Going back and forth here. The most we've ever seen teams going back and forth, never saving, I believe it was 3-2 before a team finally won two in a row.
Yeah.
Could have a crazy situation like that. We'll see. Killerfish here. Four strong into the A bomb site, but the bomb is way back. I don't know how the bomb ended up way back there, but it's just one man weaker for their take, and that could have been just what Killerfish needed. Spiker taken down to just 9 HP, but nobody from Peter goes down. And ammo, I don't know what the deal was with the bomb there. Maybe a miscommunication wanted him to follow up late or go to B. I don't know.
No, it was a classic MM. Someone threw it in spawn and he had to go back for it. It was literally that. I watched out. They all five made it to, you know, those lines right by the crate as you're going past, like this kind of the row of lines. They all made it kind of past that, and then Ammo realized that, or someone had pointed him in the direction to go back and get the bomb. So someone dropped it in spawn, and yeah, like you said, that kind of detaches a piece of their rush. So the fifth man, although in that situation, yeah, there was Spiker pretty low. They could have at least got one frag out of it. Instead, they got zero. So could have gone a lot better for them. But now they will be saving this round. So opting to save for a better gun round. Not a bad idea. And the CTs, they're going to play one at Zambags right now, and then two on each bomb site. You can see they're actually early rotating off of A. They're going to help out mid, and that's not a bad idea as they need some support from Facecrack, but he goes down as both players in mid get dropped. Now they do have an opportunity with the backstab, but Spiker goes down as well. So This is not working out at all. Luckily, though, they dropped the bomb carrier, Waylander, and then Jimka will follow up. So that one could have been close. And you know what? It is a 1v1, so things still could go the way of Killer Fish.
Now it's just a battle of position, trying to predict where your enemy's going to come from, and Waylander has the perfect read. Surely Ammo's going to go down. Oh, Waylander only tags him up a bit. So still a lot of time for mind games left here. Ammo could take either wing of the map and try to go for a flank, but instead he wants to keep pressing through middle. Now going to go through the vents. Not a lot of HP, and unfortunately for him, that vent is not broken. So he's gonna be left with going back towards middle through the smoke, perhaps. Waylander has fallen off of the smoke, adjusted towards the T-spawn side of B. And now Ammo, he's got to get his guesswork down perfect. 11 HP, he's got to hit Waylander in the head right away, and he has no idea where Waylander is. Going to go for the nade. Ah, Ammo. Going to fall to Waylander. It was made quite close by Killerfish, however, making Peter spend a good chunk of change. And coming into the first gun round, with the amount of damage they did, they could potentially have made Peter save. Yeah, if Killerfish wins this, based upon the amount of damage they did in that last round, Peter will be on the save if they lose this. So big swing round here underway. No ops for the Killerfish side. And let's see the setup for Peter. 2-1-2. I presume that's Waterfalls at mid with the op. Yes, it is. And Killerfish thinking about going for the boost up. And they do have Tony boosted up. He is cut off from the rest of his team due to the smoke at mid. And the vents boost from Peter. Good mid-round aggression from Peter. Quite early. Gives him the advantage. Now falling off of the vents. Response by Tassin, though. They're trying to take into B, but it's favoring Peter here. 4-on-3. Killerfish still yet to decide where they want to go.
Tassin, a bit of a ballsy play there as he received his frag in vents, but had the bomb in his back. So could have been very, very bad for his team if the bomb went down there. Now, actually, the bomb will be dropped in mid. Only Robson is going to take down Facecrack, so creates a 1v3, and he's got decent HP. So he might be able to make something work here. He's going to smoke into the Z connector. Head back over to Vents, but already we can see Spiker's got his eyes locked on Vents, but won't be able to find the frag, and he's going to take him down to 9 HP. They're both going to reload. He's going to drop down to Checkered. Wow, Spiker gets dropped. Robson hitting heads right now, but will be Waylander to clean up the round. Peter, another expensive one for them, but they're going to be happy with the way that rifle round went, regardless of how many guns they lost there.
Yeah, just continuing that lead. Killerfish yet to break Peter, is aside from the pistol round. And now saving up for the most part. Their round loss bonus is getting up to maximum. So they are going to be able to buy in this next round. And they're still keeping Peter at saving distance. It's not like Peter's economy has been growing out of control here. So I like Killerfish buying up a few Tech Nines here, buying just enough nades to go for a take into this A site. And for Peter, mission is to win this round not only, but hang on to as many guns as possible. So here comes the Killerfish take. Good little pop flash out of A-Man. Peter, are they going to get caught or are they going to hold from the quad? Still anybody yet to go down, but Killerfish taking in. Spiker comes up big, and they can finish Spiker.
The knife.
He gets a shank. Oh, man. Comes around the block. Knife primed out. It looks like they both tried to shank each other, too. So there can only be one Highlander, of course, and this time it is going to be Spiker.
Yeah, that was an incredible hold, as soon as he saw that they were coming in, he started spraying at Squeaky Door, and unfortunately for him, through Squeaky Door, he does decent damage, but not enough to actually kill that player, as he dropped him to about 30, so he had to swap to his pistol pretty early, and did good work with his USP as well, but then had to swap over to the third weapon, which is your knife, so he made it work for himself. Yeah, worked out great, as he's got a pretty nice wallet, pretty bulging at the moment, but we're going to see Killer Fish now. Round 7, they still only have a single round on the board. Haven't had a heck of a lot of success, as that last round they took down 2 players. In the rifle round, there was 2 players still left alive. But yeah, it's hard to pinpoint what they would like to do again here, as they are going to be boosting up in mid. But the Waterfall's holding Z connector with an AWP still. They're going to flash out for this player, and that's going to be Tassin trying to make something work, but Facecrack will present himself at white box, so they have a good defense here on the CT side, and they also have Jimka once again up inside of the vent, so a crazy defense here in mid. This is not one you really want to challenge, but they're going to go for it. Facecrack and Jimka both receive frags. Facecrack does go down, So there's one trade, but the trade is better, and especially Waylander comes into the equation. Jimco once again, and it's only Tony left, and they're just getting picked apart in mid right now. If you're going to take mid, they need to do something with it, and unfortunately, they were left with pretty much no options there. As soon as they entered mid, they were into a firing range that Peter just had their way.
And for the way Waterfalls is playing mid here, he's very susceptible to a boost peek. He's not really playing the boost. He's more peeking into main, not opting to smoke it, just tempting somebody to peek him. But all Killerfish have to do here is post Tony's op onto Z and wait for him to peek in Waterfalls. He hasn't been changing up his style one bit here at mid with the op, but with his teammates there, able to hold mid that last time. And if you run into a stack as the T's at mid, you gotta have as many numbers or have really good smokes and flashes to get out of mid. But here comes the B take. Ammo does get one, but Waylander hanging on to the checkers. Ammo pieces him off, but the damage has already been done. Face crack from middle, and now only ammo up here. Seem to have Killerfish in a lot of these one versus a whole bunch of Russian situations. But yeah, 1-on-3 here, 40 HP. Could attempt to get the bomb, to shimmy his way into the bomb site, but it's going to go back towards A, it seems. And it's all about getting this first kill if you're ammo here. The CT is going to be able to set up and have the jump on you for most of the time. Unless he can get a flank up mid here. Peter, instead of going with 1-1-1, you know, one at the site, one in middle, one in B, they're pretty spread out. And ammo doesn't know that only one guy's at the A-bomb site, going to be going back towards B, and the way Waterfalls is playing it with the op, I don't see him getting into this site. But he's going to try. Where is he going to save? I mean, with the loss bonus they're getting, not much of a point in saving. And here he comes. Going to go for the cross. Waterfalls posted up. Easy frag. And the Russians finish off that round. 7-1 here. Killerfish yet to get started on the terrace half. After they got echoed on that pistol, all Peter from there on.
Yeah, Peter's showing their dominance right now on their CT side. Again, this is Killerfish's map choice, and things are not looking good for them at the moment. They're going to go for a Tech 9 armor play, and that's a bit of frustration in my eyes, as they just want to get a round on the board, or another one other than that pistol round. They haven't had any success since then. So they're just trying to pound something out here, and it looks like they're going to go for a split B. Waylander playing front sight. He's got Jim cut inside of the sight, and already Peter just tearing them apart as not a single frag. Finally, Waylander drops. Only Oscarish left alive, and he's going to be crab walking with that P250. Finds the head of Jimka, and he's got the bomb on his back. Going to wait for them in checkered, but is not reload in time. It looked like he was mid-reload, but anyhow, that will be another Peter round. Only two frags come in. No bomb plant. Killerfish left with the same taste in their mouth that they came into that round with.
Yeah, that's not a good taste. Some old soggy fish or something.
something
what I'm
like
seeing
that.
From Killerfish, the entries from Oscarish are not here this map. And Oscarish, whenever Killerfish is playing well, is always playing well. So the young gun from Poland here, struggling on map number 2. Once again, this is our upper bracket. So whoever loses this is going to get dropped down to the gauntlet. And already map 1 being claimed by Peter. So Killerfish here.
Look at the stack right now.
Pretty dangerous territory. Where is this at? Oh, man, this is tricky. If an opera peeks them, that's pretty dangerous considering they both have rifles and we're going to see it.
I wanted the bottom of the totem pole to get dropped.
Right? It's always so funny when that happens. Like, the guy on top's just spraying away.
It's like, wait,
just falling through the air gracefully. Oh, man.
Anyhow. They are going to fall off of that boost there. Tossin opens up onto Waterfalls, but here comes the aggression from behind. But they're only able to get one. Facecrack goes down. Oscarich finding some success as he's got a double kill right now. It's only Waylander left. They found themselves in a good situation here. Again, Waylander is going to be rotating out of B. He's looking like he's going to go for it. And they've got plenty of money to go for it, as you got 14,500 on Waterfalls at the moment. But it's going to be coming up from Truck, and any frag he gets makes it expensive as well as Oscarish goes down. Ammo on 10 HP. This is doable for him. And considering Robson's the flank right now, he's coming up from mid. Needs to make his action happen soon. And oh, what a dodge there. If ammo gets dropped, that would have been huge. But wow, the nade takes down Waylander Robson. Just sends one in from long range. Hail Mary from Highway, and it goes down. So Killer Fish, they will win the round there.
Yes, they do. Killer Fish now, if they want to make their comeback happen, you got to win the second in a row. If you're at that big of a deficit and your opponent's money is pretty set, it's so important to string these two rounds together after winning one. We'll see if they could do it. Killer Fish here. Got a chance at a comeback, but if they will lose this one, that window closes. What's their strat? They got one guy pushed up inside of Sunshine over here. That's Tossin, just trying to keep him honest over here towards B. We do have a push from Peter as well, and he's trying to look on top. Wow, Tossin. He just knew. He's got hit by that way too many times. He's just going to pre-fire it. And now Peter off to a worse-off start. Waterfall is pushed up inside of the squeaky room and finishes off Tony, and he's allowed to escape as well. So good recovery here by Peter and pressing the advantage more, but Oscarish quickly comes up middle, and suddenly Killerfish are going to be able to take it to this bomb site. Oscarish with three. The young gun coming alive here when Killerfish needs it most. And now Jimka, one on two from Connector.
He's going to be coming up from Highway now. Nade comes in, doesn't do a heck of a lot as, again, it's going to be Oscarish and Robson. Good combo to have here. Robson with his AWP just holding on Squeaky. So they're playing an interesting strategy here in that Oscarish is just playing kind of out, not in the open, but he's playing the forklift, and it's a difficult angle for the CT to try and counter against, and Jimka's going to find the frag, but again, Robson, the whole idea was to hold this angle, and although his teammate drops, it's a bit of an individual play, but they're kind of throwing all of their eggs in one basket, and that Robson has to hit that op shot if Oscarish goes down, and that's what ends up happening there. You can see 10,000 on one of the CTs, but the rest of them fairly broke at this point, so he's going to drop around, but this is going to be the only drop available, as now finally Killer Fish about to put the CTs in safe territory.
Yeah, it was looking grim for them for a little while, but they can keep stringing these rounds together, potentially put Peter on the savior, or they will if they win it. And we're going to see that score line get a little tighter. And Peter, of course, would not want to allow that, and oh, on to toss an early waterfalls from middle, this time ready for the boost. And now Killerfish trying to regroup over here towards the A-bomb site. Peter do have two in the site, but rotates a little far away. Waterfall is the closest with an AWP inside of CT mid, so it's a pretty lengthy distance, but it all comes down to the entries of the Germans. And Peter, thinking about going for some pop flash aggression, this is pretty dangerous. I'm not sure if they're going to go for it. Basecraft very aggressive at the forklift. Killerfish is biding their time on this take. Already, Peter is adjusted, though, and waterfalls from the CT spawn. Killerfish just waited a bit too long. So before they take it to the site, already down two players. Face crack from the forklift. He's going to get his second of the round, and that's going to be it. Peter, avoid the save, and now Killerfish right back on it. And we're probably going to be seeing, 11-4, 12-3, something to that effect. Because Killerfish, that was one of their last chances to get a good half in.
Waterfalls being very effective as he took down a player at drop, and then the read to play truck as that smoke dissipates. He finds a frag and pretty much eliminates the execute there, as Oscarish was the player that he took down in A main, and that's the entry fragger that they were hoping to open up the bomb site. So he goes down and it all falls apart and becomes a mid play. That nade takes down a lot of HP early, as now they're coming towards Highway, but this will be an okay trade. Well, they take down Facecrack, that's about it. Robson, though, does dink Spiker to 1 HP, so might be able to find one more, but he's pinned down at White Box, and Waterfalls with a pistol in hand will take him down. Yeah, Waterfalls with 230 damage with nades. He just sent that right into mid as they all rushed out. Bit of a telegraph play, as they haven't been utilizing that smoke out mid too often on that T side. So the fact that they do so to cover the mid main entrance basically telegraphs that they're more than likely coming out mid, and that's why that nade super effective. 10-3 now, as Peter has a pretty substantial lead at this point.
That's a problem with going for a mid rush like that. Even though they had smokes up, if you don't get any kills at mid right away, it's really hard to fight players back from inside the A bomb site. They do catch up the boost here. Oscarish can't finish off anybody. Now still trying to push in as a Killerfish. They do lose two frags to one, but Waylander from the checkers, this is his domain. Always seems to get multi-frags from that location, but Killerfish do have two players to Peter's three here. Unfortunately, no bomb plant. Down goes Tossin, so only Tony. One on three. Doesn't even have control of the bomb. Looking real bleak. Still in the checkers. I don't think he's left this room for quite some time. But nobody from Peter has been peeking him. And already they have a guy on the flank, making sure that he ain't leaving. And whiffs the shot as Waterfalls, though. But the intel has been gained that Tony is still lurking around the checkers area. And still just trying to find anybody to peek him. Spiker as well as Facecrack are both peeking from Heaven and Main, respectively. But going to go down as Tony. And now Peter, 11-3, one last chance by Killer Fish. And after forcing up, they're going to have to just force up again with Tech Nines. And they tried middle with the Tech Nines with a rush. Didn't work. They tried B on that last round. Didn't work. Maybe go to A here with the Tech Nines and go for a straight rush. On your last round, do something, because your other two options just got thwarted pretty handily.
And they did try the A rush that one time where they left the bomb and spawn, but it was a bit of a detached rush. So maybe they try it again here, and actually it's a bit of a different variation, as they're going to have one go squeaky. Actually, no, they're going to fall off. Interesting. I don't know what they're doing, actually. It looked like they were going to go for some sort of early A play, but now kind of scattered as that smoke maybe prevents them from doing so, and a second smoke comes down. So, rushing A main through a smoke, never a fun time. Never a fun time at all. It's actually very difficult to get an effective pop flash in a way that you can actually safely get through that smoke. So, they are going to put their own smokes down, and that will be all right for them, but they're going to run right to a Molotov. Finally, that smoke dissipates, and Oscarish finds one head with his Deagle. Tony goes down via the AWP of Waterfalls, but they're able to get into sight. Waterfalls gets dropped, so that AWP should be now in the grasps of the T side, and that could be very nice for them, but it's going to be a 2v2 as they've got one player coming up through main. It's actually only Tossin left, and this bomb is planted default at the moment, so he needs to rush out, and that's exactly why he was doing what he was doing. Wasn't just suiciding into the bomb site. It was not planted for him, so he had to one way or another find out what was going on there. So 12-3, Peter, very dominant even on Killer Fish's map.
Yeah, it's looking like a worse beating than it was in map number one. Yeah, Peter, a team plagued by some inconsistencies, but here, Peter came to play today, so Killer Fish need to have as good, if not better, of a half that Killer Fish, or that Peter did, and unless they win pistol round, they're probably not going to have a chance to do that. So pistol round going to determine whether we're going to have a quick map, or even a potential map three, so see what happens, whoever takes that pistol round. Well, we got a little time, you guys can check out our giveaways. We got two pretty much going on today. Once we reach that 1,500 follower mark, which we're just over 100, we're going to be giving away a USP Orion. And all you got to do to get in that is, once again, follow here on Azubu. And also our CEO, David, giving away a M4 Asimov. You got to be following him at RGN David, us at RGN TV. And this is from Twitter, of course. And find that tweet, retweet it, and you are in. And we are back in the match. Killer Fish here. Last chance. Interesting buy. Going with five people with armor for Peter. Three armor, two with nades. And they're splitting this A bomb site. How many smokes are they going to set up? No, they're going to wait until they're already up squeaky. Not pre-throwing anything from the back of their spawn. And now here comes the rush. If Killer Fish don't hold this, this is going to be it. Tossin starts it off. Two big frags. Everybody from Killer Fish getting in on the action here. Wow. And a flawless one. A quick one. The moment they peeked out, about 5 seconds expired, and the round was over. Killer Fish with a good entrance into the second half.
That was fantastic. Tossin and Robson only hitting heads as they're coming into A. A beautiful crossfire as Robson was playing at quad. And, he actually got Molotoved off as well, but still found a little angle that he could just post up and, again, just find those headshots. So great round for them. Much needed here on their way to a comeback. But we see the Tech Nines, the second pistol round, as they've got armor on four players. Waylander opting against that as he wants a Molotov and smoke. And here they go. It's going to be a first frag for the CT side. Tony traded off early, though. That's going to be great. And that Molotov's going to go right underneath Oscarish, and he gets dropped. Oh, this is looking very bad here for Killer Fish. Tossin's trying to salvage things, but goes down as well through the fire as he pushed into it. It's only ammo in a 1v2, but the HP deficiency means that this should or could be an easy play, but it's up to Peter to try and make it difficult for him.
Yeah, two men to beat here. Ammo. Killer Fish need this so bad. And ammo. Gonna get peeked from both. Gets the first one. Just Waylander. Oh, Waylander peeks out. And that is so horrible for Killer Fish. Let's take a look at their money. Dang. What do you do if you're a Killerfish here? You barely have enough to force buy anything. But it's all you almost have to if you're a Killerfish here. By the time they'd have enough money to warrant a good buy, Peter would be up 15. You know, they'd even have to double save. So for Killerfish, this is their last chance. I mean, not only the previous round, they could have started to develop an economy by winning it, but now this is it. After dropping that round that they couldn't to Peter, now last chance. Going for some aggression over towards B. They do trade, but not efficiently. Peter getting the better end of it. Killerfish continuing the aggression over towards A, trying to push into the squeaky room. They got to take out this guy quickly. Teammate on the way. Now Jim trying to save the day, but Rob's just through it. Oh,
wow.
That's three hanging on to his life. Robson with the 3K and now thinking about falling back. He doesn't know Facecrack is coming up into the A entrance. So without the bomb here, Facecrack, he's going for kills.
Oh, Robson, you're nuts right now. A 4K, he peeks in the A main. Facecrack is just staring at him, and he hits that first shot right in the head and takes him down with a second body shot. Beautiful play, Robson, with the 5-7. Proving that he's one to be afraid of with an armor and a 5-7. So that works out great for Killerfish and kind of brings him back into things. Although they're still backs against the wall. Got a couple more chances now that they've fully equipped it, but they need to get through this Tech 9 round as once again, Peter not looking to give him anything at all. They line up for toss and he gets all four. Oh, sorry, Oscarish with one. Almost got all four. He got three for himself as that pop flash was great. But very dangerous as well, though, as if one of those guys looks away from that pop flash and it doesn't work out, easily could he be overrun in a rifle in their hands. But it goes the way of Killerfish, and 13-6, they're on their way back here.
Yes, they are. We might have a match here. They need to get out of this round without losing too many players, and then win that next gun round, and then we might be into it. But Peter here, still early. Still Killerfish, not with a suitable economy. But look at this from Peter, trying to boost up. They're taking their time, trying to get a couple people boosted up, but there comes the fire, falling off, and now they have a broken eco. What's left? But now they're going to try to rush out mid with Glock. It's all falling apart for them. Robson with a nade. They might be able to take the guy down on catwalk, though. Yes, they do take out Tony, so not without anything here is Peter. Now Jimka, last guy, and he's actually found his way into heaven. I'm not sure if the A guy has any idea. That's Oscarish, and yeah, he's wise to it. Somehow this man knows. And Jimka, left with a Glock. Not the, probably the worst weapon next to the scout in these clutch situations. And goes down. So Killerfish there with a somewhat clean round. They lose one player, but only losing one, your economy will still grow. But now one more round, and they could bring this to 13-9 if they take this one. And then it's into the doable mark.
Exactly. Need to get over this one more hurdle, and then mentally they're going to be in a much better state here. Tony with an AWP in his hands. Definitely one of the quiet players, as he only has found five frags in this entire map. So if he can wake up, anything can happen here for Killer Fish, as we saw Oscarish doing some good things at the end of the T half as well. So there he goes. He's going to find the first frag. Waylander goes down. He's pretty low himself, but Tony's going to follow up. Waterfalls goes down as looked like they tried to bring him up on the drop. Yeah, his body is down on the other side. Spiker goes down as well. A lot of individual peeking going on for Peter, and you can see that Killerfish is fine with this because they are putting themselves in good positions to win these duels. Now a pop flash comes into A main, and they line up. Robson continues his devastation as he peeks into A main with that pop flash from his teammate and ends the round, a flawless round. And that's fantastic. Again, they wanted to win that round. The fact that they did so flawlessly is just icing on the cake. They are well on their way. This is actually looking really good for Killerfish now.
Yeah, not looking too scary for them. They could, with this economy, you know, it's going to take a decent amount for Peter to break them. If they get out of this one without losing too many people, then Killerfish going to be able to buy up so much. And Peter still only have three rounds to get, but with an economy like this, now it's looking doable. Peter priming up over towards the A-bomb site. Nobody in position to rotate quickly. Tony, if they don't have the smoke up, could go for the cross shot.
Oh,
here
comes
into the fight. No, gets taken down. Ammo, but Robson hanging on from the back of the quad. Runs out of bullets. Tony tries to rotate in on time, but it is not on time. Bomb site, a bomb might get planted. Oh, nades the wrong person, but 3-on-3 here. And Tony from the truck.
And Tossin's coming up highway, and they do burn Jimka to death. Face crack on a Tossin, though, and this is going the way of the CTs. It's only a single piss player in Waylander, and he's going to go down. So they win the round, but make it very expensive, and they needed to after that last round went, again, flawlessly in the way of the last two rounds, actually. 21 and 20. Well, 20, they lost one player, but still pretty inexpensive for the CT side. So that one, you get a bomb plant, three kills, not too shabby at all. And ammo actually got caught out. They flashed out of A main, and you decide to pull an incendiary out literally as they breached out of A main. So he was caught with a nade out, couldn't do anything. Luckily for himself, Robson came up pretty big and at least got two before going down. But Killer Fish now gets another rifle round here, and this is the next hurdle they need to get over. Again, if they can win this one, as many as they can win before Peter takes another round. Obviously, they don't want to give them a round at all, but if they do take one, and I think they will eventually, but Killer Fish, they want to make it so they make it pretty even before that takes place.
That is the goal. Of course, perfection is always the goal. But Peter here, climbed up towards the A site. They do have Waylander waiting to peek the boost, but I think he's going to do that after the A site take is underway. Only one guy in the site here. Killerfish guessing wrong. Robson is on the way from Connector, so you're going to be in there time. But no, the Robson, he goes down. That was Killerfish's big chance in the last round. And ammo. Oh, they weren't ready for him at quad. I wonder if that's because Robson went down. Weren't expecting him there. But Killerfish bringing it down to a 3-on-2. Jimka as well as Waterfalls. Jimka comes out of the squeaky. That's not good for Killerfish now. This should allow them to get the bomb down. Killerfish is in position already. Oh, this nade could be devastating, but nobody's going for the bomb. It takes him out. That is big. Now just Waterfalls whiffs a huge opportunity. Now he's got to hit two of them, and he's going to get the bomb. Tony is in position to shut that down. So Killerfish, even though they went down early, they're able to recover. And I'm just wondering, since Robson went down at the connector, nobody even checked the close angle for quad. And that allowed ammo to get a few, and Killerfish now up 10 rounds, or got to the 10-round mark. But their economy, it's still not out of control yet.
Yeah, and I think that's really cool that you point out how Robson, again, they usually have been seeing Robson playing near quad or that little corner near Squeaky, and then ammo is playing on the highway side, either at Fork or something like that. So when ammo, or when Robson goes down, they do not expect ammo to be at this position that Robson's been playing. So some cool stuff there, but here we go. We got a mid-split as they're taking the B bomb site, or trying to anyhow. But posted up, we're going to see Tossin takes a shot through the smoke. Takes down Waterfalls, but it's going to be Facecrack and Waylander. Open up the bomb site. You see that Tony tries to help out as he's trying to salvage the fact that they're taking this bomb site. But oh, he does have a crack of the smoke here, and he takes down the bomb carrier. Waylander gets dropped. It's a 3v3, but ammo gets dropped as well, so is not looking too hot. Tony gets dropped to an aid. Only Robson playing up in heaven. 1v3. This would be a massive clutch for him.
This would, and he's crept his way out. He's just relying on nobody to peek. He takes down the first one, peeks into checkers. And Peter's pretty spread out here. Spiker's on the flank. He's just got to find Facecrack. Robson doesn't believe this area is clear. And he is 100% right. Facecrack lurks around, and that should be it. Robson had no idea that Facecrack was there. Thought he cleared, but he thought wrong. That one angle he didn't check. And that's where Facecrack is lurking. It's a little scary there for Peter for a moment. But they take that round so desperately needed. But Killerfish have an opportunity themselves here. Because Peter doesn't have the best. They didn't bring everybody into the next round with guns. So still in save territory. Here is Peter. And for Killerfish, they got an opportunity here. This is the match. If Peter wins it, it's the match for them. If Killerfish wins it, you know, they still got some work to do. But it's going to be a huge step to this victory on map number 2. Let's see. Peter here. They went with the B execute last time, and I don't think Killerfish would allow that twice. You see him kind of aggressed up, making it difficult for Peter to enter towards the checkers with that smoke up. Gonna throw another one, so eventually we might see Peter work back over there once the smoke dissipates, but very spread out here. Peter going with their default. Now a late boost in that middle. Oh no, Oscar Rich goes down over towards B and Waylander. Solo takes out both Killerfish members. That's as bad as it gets. All Peter have to do now is adjust, and that should be the round.
Yeah, Waylander playing that perfectly. Hops up under the box next to the smoke, and takes down one of the players right behind the box, and then the second player, which was Tossin, playing inside a checkered. He re-peeked after showing his angle already, and he goes down. So yeah, just some nice marksmanship. the Peter end, but bomb's gonna be set. Only Robson left, and he's gonna be coming down through CT spawn. Waylander already in position to take him down. A 3K for him, definitely MVP of the round. Waylander opened up that entire bomb site, and then ends the round with that frag. Killerfish now with one of the most broken buys you've ever seen, as they've got 4 upgraded pistols, a number of nades. Oscar is the only one able to afford an actual rifle. But being that Robson is at the frag mark, he's at 26 frags. As much as Oscarish has been known to be a high-skilled fragger himself, I think you throw that to the player that's hot in this certain map. But they're going to leave Robson just with that 5-7. And you know what? Robson had that giant 3K with one. So we'll see how it goes. But this is a big round for Peter as they take down ammo. He's going to be in spectator mode. And Killerfish can't make something happen. It would be him left in that. And he's not going to have another chance to play here.
Now, with the B aggression, Killerfish do finally take out, but Peter have their eyes on A. Only Robson here with a 5-7. He's going to do it again.
Oh, my God. Takes down two,
keeping Killerfish in this match. If they could take this one, they could try to mount a comeback. But Peter here with a chance to end it. Down goes Osterish. Only Tony here. 1-on-2 on the flank. Jimka at the side of the quad near Squeaky. Flashes out. Goes for the peak. But he escapes. So now he's going to allow his teammate Spiker to play off of him. Spiker's way back at the truck. It's very difficult position to traverse through for Tony. He's going to smoke CT off and then work up. Might be thinking about boosting himself up, but look at these smokes from Killerfish. Top of quad, the assist there by Spiker. Going to end the match 16-10. It looked like for a moment we might be going on to Cobble or Overpass, excuse me. But in the end, Peter stopped the comeback of Killerfish just short of having a close match.
Yeah, it is going to be 2-0, Peter. Moving on to our upper bracket finals. And guys, right now, our other match is still live, and it looks like it is an epic one, as it's 14-14 right now on Cash, Acer on the T side. So we'll see if that one's going to be a 2-0 or if they will push it to a third map. So definitely tune into that, azubu.tv/goRGNTV2. Or just if you browse through the Azubu website, you'll be able to find it there as well. So that's going to be it for our broadcast on channel one here. But definitely check out channel number two. There should be some more action going on. And we may have a North American broadcast. We're still trying to figure out if we can get the lower bracket finals, which is Mostly Harmless versus Lunatic, up and running. But we'll let you guys know. Make sure to follow us on Twitter, and we'll keep you up to date on all that info. But definitely jump on over to GoRGNTV2 and see the rest of that Unleashed versus Acer game. So that's it for us on channel one. Hope you guys enjoyed, but we'll catch you guys again a little bit later.
I